Suppose the removal of the tax on carbon output by utility companies reduces the cost of energy within Australia. Start with a new graph of the Australian economy at a long-run equilibrium. Capture what happens to the economy as a consequence of a decrease in the cost of energy. We'll start by drawing our graph. So we have here our y-axis, which is a price, our x-axis, which is the output. This is our short-run aggregate supply curve, which is upward slope. And this is our downward aggregate demand curve. And this is our long-run aggregate supply curve, which is the vertical line. We see that all the three curves intersect at the same point, which is point A, which will give us our potential output, which we call it full employment output, our Y star, and our price level, which is P1. Then we know that because the removal of the tax on carbon, this would result in lower cost of production. Consequently, both short-run aggregate supply curve and long-run aggregate supply curve will shift to the right. But the short-run aggregate supply curve will shift with a bigger shift compared to the long-run aggregate supply. Therefore, our short-run aggregate supply will shift to the right with a bigger shift. Now, we will have a new point of intersection between our new short-run aggregate supply curve and aggregate demand, which is point B. This would result in a higher output level, which is Y2, and a lower price level, B2. Then, we will shift our long-run aggregate supply to the right with a smaller shift. And this will be our new long-run output, which we call it our new output at full employment, which is our new potential output. We could see that here, our Y2 is bigger than our new potential output in the long run, which means our unemployment is lower than natural rate of unemployment. So what will happen is nominal wage will be higher, which would result in companies will lose the motive to produce more. Companies will be reluctant to produce more, which means aggregate supply curve will shift to the left. So aggregate supply curve will shift to the left in order to reach our equilibrium. So this means that our aggregate supply in the long run will intersect with our long run aggregate supply 2, will intersect with aggregate demand at point C. In this point, we reach our new higher potential output and the new price level, which is PLR, the price in the long run, which will be lower than P1, but higher than P2. The next part of the question is, describe in economic terms what happens as a result of the change. We know that we have a lower cost of production, which will affect our production function, which means that any company can produce more from the same labor input. Therefore, the long-run aggregate supply curve will shift to the right, which will result in lower cost, and aggregate supply in the short run will shift to the right as well, but it will shift with a bigger shift compared to the long-run aggregate supply curve. In the short run, we know that our Y2 is bigger than our potential output, which means that our unemployment is lower than natural rate of unemployment. Consequently, because of lower unemployment would result in a higher wage. This higher wage would result in shifting the short-run aggregate supply curve to the left. Therefore, in the long run, our new potential output, which is YLR, will be bigger than our old potential output and lower than Y2. Because of lower prices, I know that wages will increase. And here we refer to the real wage.